there's this great field that we call deep brain stimulation or neuromodulation, where we introduce electricity into the brain through these little straws we call deep brain stimulation leads or DBS leads, and we can push just a little bit of current, a little bit of electricity into these circuits and change the way that they're talking to each other, and that helps us to change symptoms for individual patients. Deep brain stimulation has been used in a number of different neurological and neuropsychiatric disorders, including things like Parkinson's disease and dystonia and obsessive compulsive disorder, but it's also been applied for other disorders. And so it's used for things like the memory dysfunction in Alzheimer's disease as a research tool for that. It's being used to treat tics in children and adults with Tourette syndrome. Over the last decade or two, we're beginning to see lots of new, cool technological advances that have followed the research, and the field is evolving, and now multiple companies have gotten into the field and are providing different products. The knee-jerk reaction is which one is it? Is it the red one? Is it the purple one? Is it the green one? And that's absolutely the wrong approach. So what we teach is that you should have an interdisciplinary evaluation of the patients, where you have an entire team of professionals looking at a patient from all different angles. We're in an era of precision medicine now. The choice of device should come last, after the interdisciplinary workup and after considering all of the factors that are important for an individual patient to alleviate human suffering.